Modern IoT devices connected to a hub like a home assistant running on Raspberry Pi are a perfect devices for controlling and monitoring things in our homes. Many of us still have older devices which work on sub-gigahertz frequency. One example is this 433 MHz RF outlet. Whether we are trying to control these over Wi-Fi, or if we are building something custom, having a bridge between Wi-Fi and these ISM band devices would be handy. I designed a simple PCB for controlling 433 MHz devices over Wi-Fi. This board was provided by our friends at PCBW.com, who are the sponsor of this video. PCBW.com is an affordable PCB manufacturer who offers PCBs starting from just $5 plus shipping for 10 two-layer 100x100mm PCBs. They are a great PCB manufacturer for all our prototyping and low-volume production needs. Now they also offer 3D printing and CNC milling services with large selection of different materials. Go check out PCBW.com for more information. I've had these CC1101 based RF modules for a while now. They were bought for a specific project years ago. CC1101 is a good choice for even more advanced applications, because it has lots of nice digital features allowing flexible and robust functionality, and it also has decent low power performance. What I had forgotten was that this can be configured to work just like those super cheap modules from eBay that only have one digital input or output pin. When that pin is high, module will transmit, and when it's low, module won't transmit. Receiving module works the other way. When RF transmission is detected, pin is high, and low when transmission is not detected. That mode allows transmitting and receiving with on-off keying encoding, which is used by most of these consumer RF devices. In my opinion, CC1101 is a very versatile chip, and that's why I chose to use it in this project. And for the Wi-Fi connection, I selected Wemos D1 Mini. It's popular ESP8266 port with USB connectivity, cheap price, good availability, and reasonably small footprint. In addition to CC1101 and ESP8266, I also added a header for I2C connection. Four optional modules like sensors or display. ISM to Wi-Fi bridge is the main function, but it's nice to have an option to add extra features in the future. On the software side, there's one Arduino library that makes our life much easier. It's this SmartRC CC1101 driver library, and according to its description, this library can be used for many libraries that use a simpler RF-ASK module with the advantages of the CC1101 module. So this library is used to configure and set the CC1101 module to a correct mode at a specific frequency with just few lines of code. And then another library is used for handling the actual communication. This way we can use any of the old libraries made for simpler modules, even with this more advanced CC1101 module. Library called RC Switch is a very good library for controlling RF outlets using Arduino, and the SmartRC driver library comes with many examples that use this RC Switch library. And I highly recommend browsing through example sketches when trying any new libraries. I used the example for receiving to get the codes my remote sends, then I modified send demo transmission example to send those codes. For this first test, I'm just using simple web server on ESP8266 with two links, one turns outlet on, second one turns it off. The idea is to just test the basic functionality, and it seems to work. This device could help some people get rid of multiple remote controls on their desk and control their existing RF devices from their smartphones or computers instead, even without having more complicated smart home setup. This circuit seems to work just as I planned. Thanks for watching. See you in next video. Thanks. Bye.